With the clock ticking down to the crucial midterm elections, candidates across the country are fighting to fire up their base.
You guys are voting. You're knocking on doors. You're donating.
And this is the call to action. Yes. Are you ready?
And push that energy to the polls.
I am here to ask you to vote.
At stake, control of Congress and the future of Donald Trump's presidency.
If you want to stop the radical Democrat mob from taking control of Congress, then you need to go out today, ideally, and vote.
After crushing defeats in 2016, Democrats head into Tuesday's election feeling cautiously optimistic, while the chances for the blue wave that many had predicted has diminished and Republicans are favored to keep control of the Senate, Democrats insist they have a winning chance of taking back the House.
We've been looking at sort of the possibility of a Democratic House, Republican Senate for a while now. That could still maybe get upset on election day, but I think that's where sort of the smart money is.
And we will win!
The Democratic electorate is engaged. Independents seem to be breaking for the Democrats.
And when it comes to the House, the math favors Democrats as well. Of the 70 or so House seats considered most competitive, more than 60 are held by Republicans. Democrats only need a net gain of 23 seats to retake the majority. Still, Republicans believe momentum, fueled in part by the Brett Kavanaugh Supreme Court fight and almost daily campaign stops by Trump, is on their side.
There is a true blue wave out there. It's not a wall of water. It's a head waving goodbye.
Democrats point to their strong edge in fundraising and the anti-Trump fury of female suburban voters as powerful weapons in their fight to flip Republican-held seats.
I don't like the incumbent president, and I want him to get a message that the way he's running that office is not okay.
If Democrats are able to reclaim the House, it will be the first time they've controlled the chamber since 2011. And there'll be a thorn in Trump's presidency, blocking much of his agenda and potentially opening a wide array of investigations.
The Democrats would have the full investigatory powers of the House, which I'm sure they would unleash on the White House in a way to try to damage the president in advance of the 2020 presidential race.
Though he's not on the ballot, Tuesday's midterms are widely seen as a referendum on Trump's 2 years in office.
And we are going to win, 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 and we are going to keep winning.
But history is not on his side. The president's party almost always suffers losses in midterm elections. In fact, in the 39 midterms since the Civil War, there have only been three in which the party in power didn't lose seats in the House. Kelly Daschle, Associated Press.